by no stretch of imagination can it be interpreted that the gifting within quote of the diamond by the young Dilip Singh, who was hardly 8 years old, to the Queen of England was an act of cheerful volition. It was a surrender under duress. What courage did this government display to take a stand in Supreme Court on the Kohinoor? True courage would lie not in stating the technical position, but accepting the fact that the diamond was taken away by force. The acceptance would be just as well, because we have also been able to do anything about the untold plunder of India, its peoples, jewels, and the mineral wealth under the colonial rule for centuries. Students of history tells us, madam, that Lord Dalhousie, the then Governor General of India, had acquired this stone as spoils of war after the end of Second Anglo-Sikh War in 1849. I have with me, madam, the letter that was written on 2 July 1839 by the then political agent who was stationed in Lahore to the Governor General. And that letter, clearly, letter was written to T.A. Madoc, Esquire, officiating secretary to the Government of India, with the Right Honourable the Governor General. It is a 5-page letter. It was a scroll in a sense. And in the last paragraph of that letter, because this is my demand which I would like to place before you, in the last paragraph, it's a very calligraphic letter. It's difficult for us now to read fully, but it has been retrieved, and I think if the Government of India wants to, can retrieve it from the archives.
You can give one copy to them.
I'll place it on record on the table of this house.
Much easier.
Yes. In this, the list has been given, and this states just before what happened, Maharaja Ranjit Singh was supposed to breathe his last. The situation has been explained in this letter. And in this letter, the power equation as it was changing in that palace of Lahore of Maharaja Ranjit Singh, it has been narrated. But towards the end, it is mentioned the wish of Maharaja Ranjit Singh. And here the British officer, the political agent, is writing to the Governor General. The wish of Maharaja Ranjit Singh was to donate, to gift this precious diamond to Lord Jagannath Temple of Puri. We all know Maharaja Ranjit Singh did the golden cover of Swarna Mandir of Amritsar, did the golden cover of Kashi Vishwanath Temple of Varanasi. And here is a wish which remained unfulfilled, because the Anglo-Sikh War of 1949, when the British connived or conspired to acquire that land, and that time Lord Dalhousie, who was defeated in American War of Independence but became successful here in 1857 by quashing this 1857, but this war, Anglo-Sikh War, was 1849 when it was acquired. It was not a gift. So the technical position which Government of India had taken during the 50s, that time it was that we cannot retrieve it because we are under the position of certain antiquities, and that law still prevails. And the interesting fact is what the British Prime Minister has recently said, that if we are going to return all our treasure to the rightful owner, our museum would be empty and our treasury will be empty. This is what the present Prime Minister has said of Britain. But let us not forget the sword of Tipu Sultan returned to India on the strength of the tainted money of a liquor baron whose passport has been seized. I'm not saying that we should entrust this job to that person, but I would only request the Government of India to take a position, not only in our Supreme Court, but also impress upon the United Kingdom government that this precious stone should come back to us. And here lies the story. And I would plead before this government and the members of the ruling party. Every Hindu believe that this was the Samantak money which of past which Jambavan had, which was retrieved by Lord Krishna. And till Alauddin Khilji captured it from the Kakatiya kingdoms, then only that name of Mountain of Light, as Kohinoor is called, that's why this name has been since the 14th century after Alauddin Khilji had. But it stayed with the Mughals for the longest time. And we believe, as the story goes, this money, this diamond, can only be born by the god or godhead or by woman. If this is the case, Lord Jagannath is the rightful owner. And I think Government of India would. And this is the wish of Maharaja Ranjit Singh, madam. And I would request this government to come to take all steps to retrieve that.
वैसी साहब कि आप अपनी वाइफ के नाम पे लोन लेने की क्या करो
क्वेश्चन अवर इज ओवर नहीं नहीं कोई गलत बात नहीं कही आप चिंता मत करें